Hi, welcome to This Is My Architecture. I'm Jennifer and I'm here with Mark from Marathon Oil. Hi Mark, thanks for joining us today.
Hi Jennifer, pleasure to be here.
Could you tell us a little bit about Marathon Oil?
Yeah, we're a responsible, independent exploration and production company with deep roots in American energy.
Great. I see a drone here. Could you walk us through this architecture and how it's used to solve your business problem?
Yeah, so we routinely monitor our well pads. In the past, we were doing that via people, and now we've moved to drones. So these drones are being flown by third-party pilots who are licensed, who go to every one of our well pads on a routine basis. Once they take that imagery, they're loading that imagery into a third-party software, which is actually processing all of the imagery and creating three separate files per well pad. So those three image files, one is an orthomosaic, which is a high-resolution top-down view of the well pad. We also get a digital terrain model and a digital elevation model.
So what happens when the drones capture these images?
Yeah, so once the images are created and stored on that third-party server, this is where the AWS architecture takes over. So the first event that we have is actually a CloudWatch event, which is running on a scheduled basis. This CloudWatch event is calling a step function, and that step function consists of three separate Lambda functions. The first Lambda function actually goes to this third-party software via an API and determines if there's new images and new flights available. If it does find a new flight or a new image, it will call a second Lambda function, which actually takes those images from this third party and stores them in an S3 bucket in our environment.
So what happens after these images are in S3?
Yeah, so we need to get them into our on-prem mapping software. Now, the on-prem mapping software cannot read directly from S3. So we need to call a separate Lambda function, which is actually taking these S3 images and creating what's called a raster proxy. This raster proxy serves as kind of a URL for this server to understand how to go out and actually get those images. So these raster proxies are stored in the local server's database. And from there, if I'm a user, I want to go out and actually view these images, I hit the mapping software, which via a storage gateway will come out, find those image files, and display them for our end user.
Okay. So for your on-premise servers, do you have to change the application in order to leverage storage gateway?
No, so that third Lambda function that we're using is actually what is doing that for us. So it's creating the URL that the server can make sense of, which is called a raster proxy, which allows the on-premise software to actually read directly from the S3 bucket via storage gateway.
So what happens after these index files are in S3? How do your internal end users leverage these files?
Yep, so we have a maintenance team and various other operations teams that leverage these images for a variety of reasons. Really, it's to identify any issues with equipment or see if we need to do preventative maintenance and just get an overall health check of the well pad itself.
Thank you, Mark, for walking us through this architecture. It's been really interesting to learn how Marathon Oil uses a serverless architecture to process your drone images and also be able to provide automatic monitoring of your health equipment. And thank you for watching This Is My Architecture.